Welcome to The Holy Way with Pastor Dr. Esso Olagunji, the Senior Pastor of Bible Faith Holiness Church. Pastor Olagunji preaches the unadulterated Word of God according to 1 Peter 1:16, for it is written, "Be ye holy, for I am holy." Please sit back and enjoy the message.
Father, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus, we thank you for your grace. We thank you for bringing us before you once more. As we are here again, O Lord, Holy Spirit, I surrender myself to you. Come and take control. Come and speak through me and prepare the heart of the hearer so that we understand the word and the word will transform them. Father, we just thank you. I destroy the power of darkness. Anything that will not make people understand this message and to receive it, I remove it in Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Now, we continue our message on true Christians. And I will say the number one, that who are the true Christians? The true Christians, number one, those who find the narrow way, the broad way will lead to destruction. And Satan made that many people to go to that broad way. The narrow way will lead to life, but the broad way is the way that leads to destruction. If you are a true Christian, you've been in the narrow way. And that narrow way is the way where you cannot do whatever you like. The narrow way means you are ready to do the will of God, not your will or the will of anybody. And we also said that if you're a true Christian, you will forgive sins. You forgive people that have sinned against you, trespass against you, because in the first place you were a sinner and God has forgiven you because of the death of Jesus on the cross. And that's why you have become a child of God, and God has forgiven his sin inside you. And you have to have the grace to forgive others. And he said also, number three, that you as a true Christian, you are a new creation. New Christian, you have been newly created. All things must pass away, and all things will become new. And people must see things that are new in your life. And also we said then, number four, that if you are a true Christian, those who have died to sin are called true Christian. Died to sin. Have power over sin because you have the grace. You have the Holy Spirit inside you. If you are still committing sin, no, you cannot stand against sin by yourself. But the Holy Spirit inside you is the one that will empower you to have power over sin. We empower you against sin. So now we continue. Now, number five. Those that are called true Christians they put up with sound doctrines. They'll be able to put up sound doctrines, the doctrines of holiness, the doctrine of heaven, the doctrine of love, the doctrine of righteousness. They'll be able to stand, to put up with sound doctrine. Many people, they say they are Christians, but they run away when they are preaching about sin, preaching about growth, preaching about holiness, preaching about righteousness. They only go to where they are preaching about, you know, prosperity, materialism, which Jesus was not preaching. Jesus said, don't worry about what we're going to eat. Don't worry about what we're going to put on. Your soul is more important. But these people, because they are not true Christians, they will not be able to take sound doctrine. But if you are a true Christian, is true Christian be able to put on sound doctrine? And let us see 2 Timothy chapter 4. 2 Timothy chapter 4, verse 3. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but after their own lust shall they heap to themselves teachers having itching ears. Teachers having itching ears, you know, verse 4 says, and they shall turn away their ears from the truth and shall be turned unto fables. Now, that's what happened. If you are a true Christian, you will love the sound message, sound doctrine. Because the word of God is supposed to cut away all those things. The word of God is called the sword that will cut away all those things that are bad in our life. But if you are not, maybe you are just a new believer. You would love to be taking solid. You don't want to take solid food yet. You are taking milk. But you need to grow to hear the sound word, hard messages, the messages about hell, the messages about holiness, the messages about the judgment of God that is coming. So if you are a true Christian, you will love this because you want to grow. You want to be like your Lord. So that's it. But today you see many, many people, they don't love that because they are not actually saved. They are religious people. They may be very active in the church. They may call themselves even pastors, but they won't like to touch anything, that will make, people to run away from them. No, that's why, but if you are a true Christian, you are not preaching yourself, you are preaching the word of God, because you are an instrument that God is using. Everybody, every believer, every true Christian is a minister, and you'll be able, anywhere you go, people will see Christ in you. You have boldness because you have the Spirit of God to talk about people, about this, the true thing. You can see it's Christian. The way they are behaving, you have boldness to say, no, this is not right. This is not right. So you love sound doctrine, and you want to give that doctrine to people because you are carrying the cross. You are representing Jesus because only the truth will set people free. Only the message, the sound doctrine is the one that will make people to grow. Because we need to be transformed by the renewal of our mind. The purpose of our salvation is to be like Christ. When Jesus comes, the consummation of our salvation is to be glorified. And if we are not like Christ, we will not be able to present us to the Father. So if you are a true Christian, you will love sound doctrine. And you will like to go. You stay in a church, and you are not growing, nothing is happening, then you will like to look for a place. You see, the Bible says, go around and look for the truth. And when you find the truth, stay there, because salvation is an individual matter. So you find you love sound doctrine if you are a true Christian. So you check yourself from today. What are the doctrines that I am listening to? What are the doctrines that I like? What are the doctrines that make me to be happy? Because you don't talk, the old man loves happiness. Old man wants something that is easy, but the new man wants to grow. The new man wants to have food, the bread of life to make him to grow. When a baby is born, a baby would like to be eaten like a termite because he wants to grow. So that's what happened. If you are a true Christian, you are born, truly born again, you will lack sound doctrine that will make you to grow and become like Christ. So that's number five. Number six is, they do the will of God. If you are a true Christian, you will love to do the will of your Father, which is in heaven. That is the evidence of being a true Christian, the will of God. Jesus started to do the will of his Father. And then if you are a child of God, Jesus is your brother and is inside you. You would like to be like him, to do the will of your Father. Matthew 7, that is our text, verse 21, which says, not everyone that that says unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven, but he that doeth the will of my Father. That is the condition of a true Christian. That is the evidence, the proof of a true Christian. Now, doing the will of our Father. And you see, Jesus, when the disciple came to him, teach us how to pray. And he gave them the disciples' prayer. People call it the Lord's Prayer. That is not the Lord's Prayer. The Lord's Prayer is John 17. But the disciples' prayer, say, pray like this, that our Father, which is in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, that will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Their will be done. The will of God is not done here on earth because it's Satan that's ruling here. But now, once you are a child of God, you belong to heaven. Your name is written in heaven. So you are already living the life of heaven here on earth. So if we are not going to go and learn to live the life of heaven. We have to live the life of heaven here, the life of holiness, the life of doing the will of God, the life of obedience. That is the life of heaven, the will of God. Whatever you do, Lord, is it your will or not? If you're a true Christian, before you do anything, if it is your will, let it be done. Give it to me. But if it is not your will, but people are not praying like that today. They just say, God, you have to give it to me. You have to give it to me. It's my own will. No, God will not give it to you if you are a true child of God. God will give to you something that is according to his will. You know, now that's why we say, 4 John chapter 4, says that now if we have anything, this is confidence we have in him, that we ask anything according to his will, he heareth us. But if we don't ask according to his will, if we are true Christian, God will not hear us. But what we ask, you know what you need. So you do the will of God. Jesus came, I come to do the will of my Father and to finish it. And when Jesus went to the cross, after finishing the will of his Father, it said, it is finished. It is finished. But when he started, he said, I come to do the will of my Father and finish it. And the same thing happened to a true Christian. A true Christian is only doing the will of Christ. And then he gives us the grace to live for him. We're not living for ourselves. Paul says, if I live, I live for Christ. And if I die, I die to gain. That's what Jesus said. I came to do the will of my Father. And then we have to do the same thing. Because Jesus has purchased us, we are true Christians, we have to live the life that will bring glory to Jesus and we bring glory to the Father, doing the will of God. Now, and he said the same in John chapter 9, verse 31. Because you know, God doesn't answer the prayer of sinners. People think there are certain things that God has given to everybody, whether it's a Christian or not. But certain things, if you are a child of God, that God will give to you, if it's according to his will. That is John chapter 9, verse 31. It says, now, we know that God heareth not sinners, but if any man be a worshipper of God and does his will, him he answereth. You know, this is Bartimaeus, the blind. When he was able to see, and the Pharisees were asking him, who do you think that the one that opened your eyes is? You know, he said, I know, it's not a sinner, because if a sinner, God cannot use a sinner. God doesn't answer the prayer of a sinner. This because he knows that Jesus is not a sinner, like the Pharisees are calling him. So now, if you know that your prayer will not be answered because our prayer must bring glory to the Father. So if you are a true child of God, you will not commit sin because your prayer is going to be blocked by Satan. Satan will be laughing. You have to come to me to get things from me, not from God, because you still belong to me. So as a child of God, we must do things that will bring glory to God. And what are the things that bring glory to God? Doing the will of God. Doing the will of God. When I pray, I remember when I was in America, I was praying. I wanted to go to, you know, admission to the medical school and ask somebody to come and pray with me. I said, okay, let us pray that if it is the will of God that we give in this admission. They were laughing, said, no, don't pray like that. Just, I said, hey, that's the way I want to pray. Just pray like that. Because if God will give me admission, God is going to provide money. And then when they gave to me, I say, yeah, God, you have no choice. You have to give me money because I've already said it's your will. And God provided for me. So you have to know, as a true Christian, you have to do the will of your Father in heaven, not your will anymore. The day you give your life to Christ, the day you say you are born again, you are regenerated, that is the day the Spirit of God is inside you, and that is the Spirit of Christ in you. That's why we are called a Christian. You know, because in Galatians chapter 4, verse 6 says, he said, because ye are sons, God has put the Spirit of his Father inside you, crying, Abba, Father. The Spirit of Jesus is inside us. He that has not got the Spirit of Christ is not of his. But the Spirit of Christ is making us to live a Christian life, because it is the Spirit of Christ that enables us to do the will of God. So you do the will of God. Are you doing the will of God or the will of somebody? You want to do something, you want to please people, or you want to please the Lord? You want to please the one that purchased you with his precious blood. You are not living for yourself, you are living for him. I am not living for myself because he has purchased me. I have to do his will. Whether it is easy or not, I ask the grace, the enablement to do the will of God, because it's the will of God that will bring glory to God and that will bring shame to the devil. No, you have to, as you are hearing the message, you will check, am I a true Christian? And now, do I know that I'm a true Christian? It's only by doing the will of God, which is not possible if the Spirit of Christ is not in you. The Spirit of Christ is not in me. I cannot do the will of God. But the evidence of being a true Christian, being a child of God, being a true believer, is to do the will of God. I ask the Holy Spirit to give me the grace to do the will of God. God will show you, as you are listening to this message, if you have been finding it difficult to do the will of God, you just check, am I a true Christian? Am I carrying Christ? Because Christ that was doing the will of his Father when he was here in the flesh is still inside me. He's still inside you. You just ask him, the Spirit of Christ, to give you the grace. That is the only way you can have peace as a child of God. No matter what people say, the peace is going to be there because you obey. You do the will of the Father. That is obedience. Obedience, doing the will of the Father. God will help us as we listen to this message. And then number 7, you know, a true Christian remains in Christ. A true Christian remains in Christ. You know, see John chapter 15. John chapter 15, read from verse 4. It says, abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, except it abide in the vine, no more can ye, except ye abide in me. And this is a command, abide in me. We say you are born again. If any man is in Christ, is a new creature. The Father has put you inside Christ, if you're a true Christian. And then you remain there, abide in me. Abide in me. And verse 15 says, and verse 5 says, and I am the vine, ye are the branches. He that abideth in me and I in him, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me ye can do nothing. You know, let's see now, a true Christian remain in Christ. Why? To be able to bear fruit. To bear fruit, the fruit that bring glory to the Father. Bear fruit, but if I come out of Christ, I will not be able to, the fruit I will bear will be my own fruit that will not bring glory to God. That's why I abide in him. You know, when you see the branch of a tree, you know, because the branch of a tree, the stem is the one sending food to the branch, and the branch is the one carrying leaves, carrying flowers, carrying fruit. So the fruit of the branch is the fruit of the stem. So the same thing happened. We are grafted to Jesus. We are inside him, and he's the one feeding us. And the fruit that will come out must be his own fruit. And the fruit that is coming out must be the fruit that brings glory to him, that will bring shame to the devil. That's why if you're a true Christian, you abide in Christ. You abide in him. That is where the Father has put you. That is where the Father has put me. And the reason why he has put me there is to bear fruit. And again, not only to bear fruit, Satan will not be able to touch me. Because you see, now before enemy will touch you, is going to touch the Father, touch the Son, because the Son is in the Father. And you are in the Son now. Enemy, before enemy will touch me, is going to touch the Father, touch the Son before touching me. That's why I abide. Because the name of God is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and is saved. You are secure. You know, I mean, it's even James chapter 4, verse 7 says, submit yourself to the Lord and resist the devil. he will flee from you. Remain, submit yourself, remain there. Don't come out. If you come out, the devil is going to catch you. So abide, remain. And then when you abide in me and my words that is coming abides in you, is the word that now that will make you to bear fruit. I am the vine, ye are the branches. He that abideth in me and I in him, the same bringeth forth fruit, much fruit. For without me ye can do nothing. And verse 6 says, if a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch and is withered. And men gather them and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. So if you're a true Christian, you abide. That is, you remain where you are put. The Father puts you in Christ. And then you are doing the will of the one. Because Jesus said, abide in me, and I myself, because your spirit and the spirit of Christ mingle together. So that's why Jesus said, you abide in me, I am in you, and you are in me. Because we are tripartite. We are three. As you have the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, we are tripartite. That is three part. We have the body, spirit, and then soul. That our soul is just like body, like this, and our spirit also. But Jesus, the Spirit of God, is in our spirit. So controlling our spirit. That's why we are together. Say, abide in me, and I abide in you. If a man abide in me, if a man abide not in me, he is cast forth as a branch. You know, that's if you are not in Christ, if you are not a true Christian, you will not be able to remain in Christ. But if you are a true Christian, you abide. And verse 7 says, if you abide in me and my words abide in you. That's why you hear the sound word, the sound doctrine, the word of Christ, the word of holiness, the word of righteousness, the word of truth that will make you to grow, that will make you to know where you are, that you are representing Christ here on earth. If ye abide in me and my words abide in you, ye shall ask what ye will, and it shall be done unto you. That's the reason you have to abide. So, because whatever you want to bring, the fruit is not yours, is to bring glory to him. The more you are bringing fruit, the more God will be increasing, you know, the power to bear more fruit. Here is my Father glorified, that ye bear much fruit. So shall ye be my disciples. The disciples of Jesus are called true Christians. As I said, in Acts of Apostles, chapter 11, 20-26, the disciples are false Christians. So because it's in you, and you are his disciples, because you are bringing out is fruit, not your own fruit. So a true Christian must bear the fruit, must abide. And the word will make you to grow. The word is the food that you are eating. That is bread of life. It's very important to understand that, brothers and sisters. If you are not abiding, if you are not bearing the fruit of Christ is what it brings glory to the Father. Therefore, you have to check, am I a true Christian? God will give you the grace. Are you in the narrow way? Are you enter in through the narrow gate? Or how did you enter? When they preach the gospel to you, what type of gospel did they preach? Is it another gospel? Or the gospel of our Lord Jesus that died on the cross? Because if you are the only person in the world, that's how Jesus will come and die for you, because he's the one that created you. All things were made by him. Without him was not anything that was made. In the first place, he's your creator, and you are lost. Like anybody that was lost, he came to look for us, to bring us back to him. And when he has brought us back, he's inside us, and we're inside him, so that we'll be able to control us. It was Satan's spirit that was controlling us before, but it's him now. You have to know that. Is he controlling you? Is he guiding you? Is he leading you? Is he commanding you? Are you obeying him? Jesus said, if you love me, keep my commandment. That is the evidence to show that you are my disciple, that you are a true Christian, that you are carrying Christ inside you. The life you are living is the life of Christ, the life that obeys the Father. And because you are now a child of God, you have to obey the Father through our Lord Jesus Christ. Everything Jesus says, without me, you can do nothing. You cannot obey God by our own power, but because that's why Christ is inside us. And then you obey the Father because Jesus has reconciled us to the Father, and the Spirit of the Father is inside us, and Jesus is inside us to be able to do the will of the Father. The will of the Father will bring glory to the Father, and we bring joy to you. We bring happiness. Whatever, say whatever you ask, the Father will give it to you. Why? Because you are obeying him. You know, you are doing the will of the Father, and you are not living for yourself. Everything you need, you ask, and God is going to give according to his will. If it's according to his will, because it's the joy of the Father. Your joy is the joy of the Father. God wants you to want to enjoy you, and he wants you to enjoy him as well. So whatever you are, God wants to be glorified in our life. So that's why you need to abide. You need to live the life of Christian, because Christian means the life of our Lord Jesus. He that has not got the Spirit of Christ is none of his. Now you have got the Spirit of Christ, then that's the proof. But you live it out. How will people know? By living the life of Christ. You know, that is the evidence. The life of obedience, the life of holiness, the life of doing the will of God, the life of hating sin, the life of loving holiness, righteousness. That's the life of a true Christian. God will give you the grace to do the will. God will make you to correct your way. And then we don't know when the Lord will come. When he comes, you will not miss him. In Jesus' name. Father, I just thank you. I give glory to your name, Lord, as the people, the little way I'm able to present to them, Lord, let the Holy Spirit give them the understanding. Lord, I pray that the Holy Spirit will make it real in their heart so that they will be able to know that I'm just a voice. The word has come out. The word is Jesus himself written. And then the word will become real in them and their life will transform, so that you will snatch them away from the devil. They will live the life that will glorify you and shame the devil. And you make them happy. You give them their heart desire because they obey you. They live the life of your son. Father, I thank you. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray. Amen.
Thank you so much for watching today's message with Senior Pastor Dr. Esso Olagunju. We trust that you have been blessed. If after hearing today's message you want to give your life to Christ, please repeat after me. Dear Lord Jesus, I come to you as a sinner. I confess and forsake my sins and surrender my life to you today. I believe that you died on the cross for me. I accept you as my Lord and Saviour. I declare that I am born again. For more information, please visit our website at BibleFaithHolinessChurch.org or call us on 0208 539 0886 or visit us at Bible Faith Holiness Church, 70 Grange Park Road, Leighton, London, E10.